These early stunt pilots shared the joy of flight as spectators of all ages watched in amazement. Led one of the very first military demonstration teams, the Men of the Flying Trapeze. Edward Curtis Hawk biplanes, constructed of wood, fly wires, and fabric-covered wings. Chenault later led the famous flying trapeze. Just like the Man of the Flying Trapeze, Ed Hamill flies his fabric-covered wing machine. Barnstorming its way across the world. The Air Force Reserve enables Ed to follow his dreams as both a civilian and a military officer serving his country. EdHamill.com and start sharing ideas about how you are living your dreams. So did air races, and soon competition. Let's watch as Ed dives his dream machine toward show center, looking for three winglets. In April of 1948, the Air Force Reserve was born. And international aerobatic competitions were in full swing. With rules set and judges in place, competitors had to stay inside a 3,300-foot squared aerobatic box. Competition flying is more technical than barnstorming. Pilots are graded on maneuvers like point rolls and vertical lines. Just like the Air Force Reserve, competitive aerobatics requires has flown his dream machine in many competitions, including three U.S. National Aerobatic Championships, qualifying for the 2002 U.S. Advanced Aerobatic Championship. Ed's full biography can be found on his website at edhamill.com. At the present day, 2005. Just as the Wright brothers followed their dreams at Kill Devil Hill in 1903, Ed's dream is to skydance for you. Look up and watch as Ed begins the dance. as Ed performs maneuvers like the centrifuge, snap rolls, and outside turns. The negative G and gyroscopic forces are more physically demanding than the structure violence.
Thank you.